What's going on, Cast Productions fam? If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you've been here, welcome back to KP Cast Production Takis Taste Test Reviews, where friends request friends to eat Takis.
Yeah.
Today we're going to be trying Takis Episode 7 Flavored Buckin Ranch. Everyone, welcome back to my Takis series. It's been a couple months and I got a new flavor of Takis here. And also a special guest on my channel that's been here on for a while. Mason?
Hello. This is an exciting adventure and the first time I've ever been in a Takis video, even though we've been friends since 2015.
That is true. My long-standing Takis review has had many guests. However, none of them have been my good friend here, Mason. And so today that changes. And this is also a bit of a special send-off to Mason's old Bessie Starlight car, Annie.
It's just Starlight.
Sorry, my bad. It's just Starlight. And it's basically dead, so he's selling it to a new owner who knows what they'll do with it. Hopefully give it a new good home and not scrap it for parts. After all, this is a luxury vehicle. Without further ado, let's just get into the Takis. This is Buckin Ranch flavor, non-spicy. I've had this bag for many, many months now, and I've been meaning to do a review of it, but just haven't gotten around to it. Because these Takis videos are very special, and you got to make them really count. So, if you'll just hold the mic here, I'll get this opened.
Where did you get this bag of Takis?
I got it in Walmart. And if I'm not mistaken, I think these were... I couldn't find them at my local one in Orem, so I drove to this one. In Cedar Hills, and I found them there, if I'm not mistaken.
Let's hope you're not mistaken.
So,
you should listen to this. Oh yeah, I bet that sounds pretty good.
It does sound pretty good. And let's give it a smell. Not too strong on the smell there, honestly. A little bit, but not too strong. And this is non-spicy, so this is going to be a lot different from the Takis that I'm used to. I usually eat the Fuegos, so that's my go-to. Still the goat, always will be.
I like the guac ones.
Yeah, the guac is good too.
I've had only three types, the blue ones, and the regular, and the guac ones. I like the guac the best.
I remember one time we ate guac ones and Nick Manzano's car, and it stunk up the whole place.
Oh yeah, I do remember that. I do. That's funny.
So, well,
how's this work?
We just eat one. Each, let you reach in there and grab a Taki. And as you can see here, through this windshield, and this is barely visible, I'm aware, but you know, this is a special episode for the Buick send-off. We've got the logo perfectly framed, more in the shot than us. But you know, it's not about us, it's about the Takis and the Buick. So, there you go.
Takis and Buick.
And let's give these a try, without further ado. Well, it tastes like Cool Ranch Doritos.
It does. That's exactly what it tastes like.
Yeah. Not spicy at all, like they say. And if I'm not mistaken, I think the one of the previous Takis reviews I did with Ben almost a year ago now, they also tasted like Cool Ranch Takis. Can't remember the flavor of that one. It was cheesy something. But, yeah, this tastes pretty much just like them.
Yep, it's just Cool Ranch.
And it does say ranch here, Buckin Ranch. But not getting any southern old western vibes from this. Just really tastes like a Cool Ranch Dorito. I mean, almost exactly like that.
I like ranch as much as the next guy. But yeah, it's just all right.
Yeah. I am a pretty big fan of Cool Ranch Doritos. They're definitely my favorite flavor of Doritos. Although Spicy Sweet Chili is a pretty good one.
That's my favorite.
It's also vegan, so shout out. So honestly, my review is, it just depends on which shape you like more. Is a nice tubular Taki shape or a triangle shape? Whichever one you like more, honestly, go with those chips. Because I know these are still in stock. I see them at Walmart all the time. I don't think they're limited edition. I think it's part of Taki's main selection these days, so really, whichever one you like better. If you're a fan of Cool Ranch and you're looking for a more tubular chip, I'd recommend these.
Yeah, I agree. They just taste the same, so do whatever you want. Speaking of Takis,
I mean, almost exactly the same.
Yep. I dated this girl like a year or two ago, and she told me how she ate Takis. Was she took them and sucked off all of the flavoring and then put them back in the bag. She didn't like the chip part, just the flavoring. And I really looked down on that. And it's one of the many reasons that we are no longer dating.
That's interesting, yeah. Shout out, I mean, at least she appreciates the spicy, nice flavor of it, but not eating the chip is pretty weird. It kind of goes hand in hand. It's like, you know, like you don't just eat the Fun Dip powder, you eat it with the stick, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
They go hand in hand. You can't just have one or the other, in my opinion.
Yeah, and it's fine that you just like the flavoring, but why do you got to put the chip back into the bag? The wet, saliva-y foul chip.
Yeah, that's pretty foul. Like, just have, like, a trash can on standby. Or just, like, take a mallet and just crush them into a fine powder that, I mean, cut out the middle, man, just straight powder.
Yeah, she gave me a raspberry on my belly one time. And that is literally the reason I broke up with her. So,
that's pretty weird.
She was a weirdo. Anyway, the reason I said that is because Takis always remind me of her now because of that weird thing that she does.
Tainted association there.
Yeah, it's too bad. Overall, the chip's good, though. I mean, Taki doesn't miss very often, at least from the ones I've tasted. It's not my favorite, but it's not the worst either.
Yeah, I'll pretty much finish this bag over time and then just go back to my regular Fuegos. I buy the mini pack of... looks like a cat's escaping there. I buy the, like, the 25-pack of the mini Takis, and pretty good. Usually bring one to work with me. Mm-hmm. Good little snack.
Yeah, I like Fuego, too. The goat.
Yeah, I think it'll always be the goat. Mm-hmm. Nothing can ever top it, I mean, probably. Blue Heat tastes pretty similar, but there's a fine distinction, and the blue powder is a little off-putting compared to the red, in my opinion.
True, it's unnatural.
However... Takis, I think, is rated with Red 40, which we all know is also bad.
Causes autism.
Yeah.
I made that up. So.
So do vaccines, so.
Yeah, vaccines and Red don't, 40.
Don't eat Takis.
And get goldfish cause ADHD. I've heard.
Yep. That is true.
Mason's my Buick is going home. My Buick is going home to a new home. My Buick is going to a new home. My Buick is going to a new home. Why do you have to say goodbye?
If you say, because of the, it doesn't work anymore. Doesn't work anymore, so it has to go to a new home.
I want to sit in a driver's seat and drive a car.
What's the problem with it? The spark plugs are gone?
I don't even know the problem with it.
It's just completely bricked.
It's bricked.
So Mason has to sell it to a new home.
I have to sell it to a new home.
Mason has to sell it to a new home.
Some guy tried to lowball me and offer me $300. And he's gonna be a congressman for the United States of America. Honk, 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 honk. I want to warn against other people driving.
Honk!
So pick up the keys and start driving. Oh, yeah. I want to talk about what I have learned with the car manual and everything that I've learned in the car.
Honk, 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 honk.
I...
Honk, 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 honk.
No, one last drive.
Relax, have a seat with me.
One last drive.
We'll see the sights that we're meant to see.
And then we'll teach the car how to stay and drive. You and I.